Very often people say to me, but if this little insect disappears, surely it doesn't make any difference, does it matter? And the thing is that everything is interconnected, and that little insect might be the major food source of some other creature, who then might disappear as well. And so it goes on with this interrelationship. We call it biodiversity. I like to call it the web of life, all the strands forming a beautiful pattern. And that pattern is being destroyed. Here are all these problems which we've inflicted on the planet. And it brings me back to the sort of really important question. I've talked a lot about similarities in humans and chimpanzees, but clearly we're different. I mean, look, here we are, and you're listening to my words, and I'm telling you things you may not want to hear them, but I'm saying them and you understand them. And the biggest difference, I believe, between us and chimpanzees is this explosive development of our intellect. I mean, chimpanzees can do things we thought that was impossible, but we just created a rocket a few years ago, which went all the way up to Mars, the red planet, and out came a little robot. And that little robot is still crawling around years later, taking photographs for scientists on planet Earth to see what it looks like up there. That's extraordinary. When I was a child, it would have been science fiction, but we've done it. So the question is, how is it possible that the most intellectual creature that's ever walked on planet Earth is destroying its only home? We're destroying Mother Earth so fast. Do you think perhaps we've lost wisdom? The wisdom that some indigenous people showed, making a decision based on how will this affect our people generations ahead? Are we too often making decisions based on how will this help me now, or the next shareholders meeting, or my next political campaign? Is there a disconnect between this incredibly clever brain and the human heart, love and compassion? And I truly feel that we can only achieve our true human potential, which is huge, if we have harmony between head and heart. It's not a bit surprising to me that as I was traveling around the world, I met many young people who seemed not to have much hope for the future. And many of them were angry. Some of them were violent. A lot of them were depressed. Most were just apathetic, didn't really seem to care much about anything. And when I asked them why they were feeling like this, they all said more or less the same. You've compromised our future and there's nothing we can do about it. We have compromised your future. When I see small children, I feel so ashamed and angry and desperate when I think how we've harmed the planet since I was that age. But is it true there's nothing that can be done? There are many biologists who will tell you so. But I'm not alone in saying we have a window of time, a window to start changing the direction. But it depends on changing attitudes. And if we could just get a critical mass of us who start to think about the consequences of the little choices we make each day, what we buy, what we wear, what we eat, how was it made? Did it harm the environment? Did it involve cruelty to animals or people, child slave labor, this kind of thing? And I think most people, even though they've become aware, do nothing because they feel useless and helpless and hopeless. They tell me so. So we just have to get it through to our thick heads that what we do as an individual, certainly in the big scheme of things, doesn't make a difference. But what we do collectively as billions of human beings making the right ethical choices, that's going to move us in the right direction. If our young people lose hope, we may as well give up. Let's learn to live in peace and harmony, first of all with each other, between religions and cultures. Gosh, we have a long way to go, don't we? But also between us and Mother Nature. Because if we go on exploiting Mother Nature the way we are now, then all will be in vain. each and every one of us makes a difference each and every day. And we have a choice. What kind of difference are we going to make?